20 yards. Olympiad. O sport, thou art peace. There are many wonderful legends on the origin of the Olympic Games. The oldest of the surviving ones says, Greece was locked in internecine warfare in the 9th century BC. In order to stop the bloodshed, the ruler of Olympia, King Iphitus, opened the Olympic Games and proclaimed, henceforth, all wars will cease during the Games. May he who comes to Olympia in arms be punished. Sometimes, in defiance of their ruler's will, the enemies of yesterday stream to this pageant of peace to make up with one another and to match their ability in sports competitions. The flower of Hellenic culture converged in Olympia together with the athletes. Demosthenes, the famous orator. Pythagoras, the great mathematician. And even Diogenes, the hermit philosopher. Poets and musicians, artists and actors showed their skill here. Pindar, the lyric poet, praised Olympia in his odes. Do not seek a star hotter than the sun, whose rays warm up the whole world through empty air. And for my songs too, nothing is more beautiful than the Olympic Games. Millennia have passed. Olympia, a land of ancient Greece, glorified with legends. According to traditions passed down through the ages, every 4 years, the high priestess of the Temple of Hera ignites the sacred Olympic flame with sun rays. For the last 16 years, the part of the high priestess has been played by a splendid Greek actress, Maria Mascolou. In relays along the roads of Greece, Bulgaria, Romania, and the Soviet Union, 5,000 runners carried aloft the sacred Olympic flame to the venue of the Olympic Games in Moscow. O sport, thou art peace. Directed by Yuri Ozerov. Scenario by Yuri Ozerov and Boris Richkov. Text by Nicholai Dobronravov. cameramen Orlanovsky, Maximov, Oshurkov, and 102 other cameramen. Alexandra Pakhmutova. The Olympic symbol is five interwoven rings. The Olympic Games are the symbol of the dream that people on all five continents of our planet will as firmly take one another by the hand and live peacefully under a clear blue sky. Moscow welcomed its guests. They came to the Olympic Games with cameras, horses, boats, bicycles, sabers, boxing gloves, and high hopes. President Leonid Brezhnev of the Soviet Union and President of the International Olympic Committee, Lord Michael Kilinin, arrived to attend the opening ceremony of the Games of the 22nd Olympiad.
Леонид Ильич Брежнев.
Majestic chariots, we pay tribute to the ancient land of the Hellenes. We pay homage to noble sport, which knows no boundaries, of the eternal and wonderful spirit of the Olympic Games.
Здравствуй, самый мирный на свете стадион моей мечты. Одержимость, путь к победе, спорта нет без красоты. Жажда счастья, жажда рекорда и борьбы прекрасный миг. Мастера большого спорта учат рыцарскому груди. Здравствуй. Москвой стадион. Не мечты, а стязаются. Москвой стадион. Где рекорды сбываются.
Там с тобой, Хрущев, этот мир солнечной радости. Спорт от лагеря дождем. И дождем для побед.
The noble ideals of the Olympic movement brought together in Moscow more than 6,000 leading athletes of all continents of the earth. The way to Moscow was not easy for the sport delegations of some countries. There was a campaign to boycott the games, and this cannot be passed over in silence. Mr. Otto Simasek, director of the International Olympic Academy, said,
"It's a pity that not all countries have participated, and it is most probably due to the political interference in sports, which we are trying to avoid. Because in accordance to the Olympic principles, there should not be any discrimination of political, religious, race, or any other kind of discrimination between people."
American tourists were asked if they weren't sorry their champions weren't there.
"Yes, very much. I think that they would have enjoyed themselves and made a great contribution here, and I feel they were robbed of a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity."
Mr. Miyakawa, Vice President of the International Sporting Press Association.
"These athletes should be marching among the athletes of the world. I regret that situation, and I think that is a feeling of all the sportsmen in Japan. But this is because of reasons which are not of sports, but some political thing which I regret very much."
"Ich bedauere ebenfalls und unsere Touristen bedauern ebenfalls ganz außerordentlich, dass..."
"We are deeply disappointed," say tourists from the Federal Republic of Germany, "that our athletes were unable to participate in the Olympic Games. Most of them would have liked very much to come here, but were not allowed to."
"The struggle decisive and honest, and the force must be restored. That's the battle for the strongest, and let's call it sport. When the sportsmen stand together, they'll contest if not short. Our friendship lasts forever, our friendship means big."
Председатель Организационного комитета Олимпиады 80 Игнатий Трофимович Новиков.
Игнатий Новиков, chairman of the Olympiad 80 Organizing Committee. I have the honor of introducing Lord Killinan, President of the International Olympic Committee, whom I greet most warmly.
I would like to welcome all the athletes and officials here today, especially those who've shown their complete independence to travel to compete, despite many pressures placed on them. I ask you all to compete in the true spirit of mutual understanding above all differences of politics, religion or race, in the wonderful facilities provided here. I have the honor to invite President Leonid Brezhnev to proclaim open the games of the 22nd Olympiad of the modern era.
Esteemed Mr. President of the International Olympic Committee, sportsmen of the world, dear guests, comrades, I declare the Olympic Games of 1980, celebrating the 22nd Olympiad of the modern era, now open. Thank you. The sun-ignited flame was lit in the Olympic Yachting Regatta Center, the city of Tallinn. In the heroic city of Minsk. In the heroic city of Kiev. In the heroic city of Leningrad. The Olympic mascot, Misha the Bear Cub, came into sight. It seemed as though this charming and kind creature had emerged from an old Russian fairy tale. He very much wanted the athletes and tourists to like him, and like him they did.
Thank you.
100-meter sprint. Eight of the Olympic Games' fastest women in the final, among them the world record holder, Ludmila Kondratyeva. Kondratyeva is the Olympic champion. The path to the stars is difficult, and the path of an Olympic star to the summit of world fame is even more so. Victory means joy and pain and tears of happiness. The men's 100-meter sprint. On your marks, medal-winning spurt to the tape by Alan Wells from Scotland. This is a wonderful moment for Alan Wells, the first British sprinter to become an Olympic champion in the last 56 years. Most respected forms of competition in ancient Olympia. Consecrated by age-old traditions, the sporting rules were observed strictly. Their slightest violation was punished immediately on the spot. Times when the violator himself forced a change in the Olympic rules. In the games of the 14th Olympiad, young Orsippus lost his clothes. But he was first at the finishing line, far ahead of his rivals. It was such a brilliant victory, and the joy of his fellow countrymen was so great that the judges could not deprive Orsippus of his award. From that time onward, all the male athletes competed in the nude. There was no higher title in Greece than that of Olympionik, a champion of the games. When an Olympionik returned home, a breach was made in the fortress wall and then filled in again so that victory would never leave the town. Yes, the years race by and athletes keep running faster and faster. Times are now counted not down to seconds, but to tenths and hundredths of a second. But hasn't our whole life become as hectic?
Thank you. Moscow, Великобритания, 3 минуты 38, 40 сотых секунды.
Sebastian Coe triumphs in the 1500 meters to bring the second Olympic gold medal to the British team.
Sebastian Coe, Great Britain, winner 38.4 gold seconds.
The Ethiopian long-distance runners, headed by Mirut Siefter, used clever tactics. Siefter, true to his style, stayed in the shadows until the final lap of the 5,000 meters, when he showed the rest of the field a clean pair of heels. The 10,000 meters. All the runners had already become thoroughly acquainted with Yifter's famous closing burst of speed, but there was nothing they could do about it. In one way, it was very hard for Yifter. He was 36, older than all his challengers. In another way, it was easy for him, because he was wiser than the others. Sport is a combination of inspiration, talent, and wisdom. The most anxious to hear about their father's victory probably were his six children in far-off Ethiopia. The 110-meter hurdles. Thomas Munkelt of the German Democratic Republic steals the victory from Alejandro Casanas of Cuba. But the main thing is not winning, it's taking part in the Olympics. The 3,000 meter steeplechase. No wonder commentator Tomaszewski is so excited. The Polish athlete Bronisław Malinowski is the Olympic champion.
Thank you.
Pietro Mennea, the Italian sprinter. The event is the 200 meters. God helps those who help themselves is a popular saying. Mennea helped himself. The marathon, a race covering 42 kilometers, 195 meters. Be careful, starter. Don't fire your pistol ahead of time. Marathon, in Greece, is where 10,000 Athenians, under the command of the Greek strategist Miltiades, routed the army of King Darius of Persia in 490 BC. A Greek soldier, Pheidippides, was sent to Athens with the joyous tidings. He ran from the plains of Marathon across hills and small streams. The distance of 42 kilometers to Athens, which he ran, subsequently became the modern marathon, the road race. Pheidippides ran up to the place where the first Olympic stadium was built. Legend has it that he shouted, "Rejoice, we have won," and fell dead. "Let's hope he didn't," said Baron Pierre de Coubertin. He was happy that he reached his destination. People shouldn't die from happiness. Electronic machines haven't been invented yet, which can read thoughts. It would be interesting to know what's on a marathon runner's mind during that exhausting competition. Let's listen to what Richard Hooper of Ireland has to say.
42 kilometers. 42 kilometers plus 195 meters, as if 42 kilometers aren't enough. Usually you don't have the strength left for those 195 meters. I'm not ambitious and don't like to overstrain myself much. And frankly, I'm not counting on an Olympic gold. But my brother Patrick and I are keeping a score of our own. You see, he's beginning to pull up.
Thank you.
Ancient Greek hadn't run the whole distance, would there have been a marathon event at all? It's great fun racing on a stadium track in front of the public and with the girls looking on. Oh, I should have run the 5,000 meters like Mam advised and already been under the shell by now.
Meanwhile, a decisive moment had been reached in the triple jump. The top favorite here was the Brazilian world record holder, João de Oliveira. Effort was 17 meters, 22 centimeters. The young Soviet entrant, Yakub Meyer, makes his try. Centimeters, a strong bid for the laurels. The draw put triple Olympic champion Viktor Sanyeev last in the line of hop, step, and jump contestants. He realized that this time all objective factors were against him. He was 35 years old and had suffered injuries. And there was that sudden headwind. Viktor waited for it to die down. Judges measured his clearance as 17 meters, 24 centimeters, 2 centimeters better than that shown by Oliveira. This meant a silver medal for Sanyeev to add to the 3 previous golds gained in Mexico City, Munich, and Montreal. A dozen Olympic years is a long sporting life, but Viktor thinks to himself, what a short sporting life it is. And it's with good reason that later on the awards podium, Oliveira told Udmay, "You're the winner, but the best man among us all is Sanyeev."
Thank you.
Times have I sworn that I'd give it up, but Patrick beat me last time. The main thing in the marathon is to hold out. Hold out. Leading, that's nothing. It happens sometimes.
Champion Valdemar Sierpinski of the German Democratic Republic is the first to end the tough marathon race.
I'm in the 38th place, which is not bad at all. A lot of the other fellas, including even that famous Finn, Lasse Virren, dropped out altogether. I didn't. Where's Patrick? Ah, there he is. I'm 38th, and he's 42nd. I'm the winner. Yes, that brother of mine, Patrick, is a fine fella.
Here is another marathon event in cycling. The 14 laps, 189 kilometers, have to be negotiated by 115 cyclists from 32 countries of all the continents. Margin of 3 minutes is Soviet cyclist Sergei Sukharchenkov. Sports commentators may soon be calling him the best cyclist in the world. The Olympic rowing course in Krilatskoye. Thank you. The world's best, said the singles skulls winner, Pertti Karppinen of Finland. But Krylatskaya proved to be best of all for the Olympic rowers of the German Democratic Republic. The blue course waters were gilded by their sparkling victories. They took 11 out of the 14 contested gold medals. The Baltic wind filled the sails of the Olympic yachts in Tallinn, the capital of Soviet Estonia. Whoops. The medals went to challengers from a dozen nations. Two gold medals went to the sailboat crews of Brazil, and one apiece to those of Spain, Denmark, Finland, and the Soviet Union. Swimmers from 43 countries competed in the Olympic swimming pool. One of the sensations in the Moscow Olympics was caused by 15-year-old Rika Reinisch of the German Democratic Republic, who set three new world records. Duncan Goodhue of Britain caught the attention of the swimming fans at once when he showed up wearing a checkered cap. Perhaps it was the swimmer's talisman. Here he prepares for the start of the race. And indeed, he was the winner. But attention naturally was focused on the men's 1500-meter final. Everyone expected a world record from the 20-year-old Soviet swimmer Vladimir Salnikov. Kolesnikov steadily increased his lead. And when he touched the pool edge, the stopwatches showed the remarkable achievement of 14 minutes, 58.27 seconds. The first time that a human being ever swam 1,500 meters in under 15 minutes. World sports commentators would declare Kolesnikov's record the outstanding one and would later vote him the best sportsman of the Olympics. Watching this race, it can be said in all confidence that Kolesnikov's record will be broken soon enough. Remember the faces of the future champions. The high jump is the most romantic event in athletics. When in defiance of all the laws of gravity, and in spite of the saying that there's no jumping higher than one's head, people do soar up and over the bar like birds. The audience becomes silent and holds its breath in anticipation of a miracle. So let's have silence and simply look on. Athletics is called the queen of sports. It would be more exact to say that athletics is a whole kingdom. The queen of this kingdom on that day was the Italian high jumper, Sara Simeone. She ruled supreme. Sara, in childhood you prepared for a career in ballet to thrill the public with your skill. It must seem to you right now that you're on stage. A prima donna of world athletics.
Высота. Я с детства рвался под небесье. Со мной осталась навсегда моя не сдавшаяся песня. Сквозь облака тревог блеснет зари улыбка. Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка.
Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка. Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка.
Блеснет зари улыбка и свет ее высок. Не взята, не смей до страха опускаться, она коварна высота, она не любит покоряться. Облака тревог, блеснет зари улыбка. Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка.
Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка. Еще один рывок, еще одна попытка.
Блеснет зари улыбка и свет ее высок. Небосвод и звезд серебряные чащи, я вижу свет иных высот и слышу голос твой летящий на свет. Высоты.
78 centimeters. This is the new world pole vault record set by talented Polish athlete Vladislav Kazakiewicz. Stronger. In answering this call, man comes to know himself. The Olympic Games means looking to the future. The champions and record breakers are the scouts, the trailblazers, struggling to extend the limit of human possibilities. No wonder, therefore, that we are so keen to follow their struggle, which is both uncompromising and fair, and with an unknown outcome each time. Prior to the Moscow Olympics, experts regarded Polish Jacek Szola, the previous Olympic winner, as the unquestionable top bidder for the gold medal in the men's high jump. Of the German Democratic Republic ranked 48th in the world classification, and his chances in Moscow were discounted. All predictions and became the Olympic champion. The bar was set at an unprecedented height of 2 meters 36 centimeters. It was a a fantastic height and a fantastic achievement. And yet this is probably not the limit. It has been the age-long striving of people to rise to greater heights. No wonder mankind has already made the first jump to the stars. Evening is a good time to roam through the city, to listen to the sounds of its streets dying down, and to admire the sparkling dance of its fountains. Each day of the Olympic Games, the names of its heroes were announced. Incidentally, those people who put their whole heart and soul into organizing the Games were also considered Olympians. Over a number of years, the builders worked according to the Olympic credo and impatiently looked forward to the time when athletes would appear in the Olympic Village. Moscow has, since time immemorial, been known for its hospitality. It can be said in all confidence that the Olympic Games were like a welcome guest. Muscovites did everything they could for the Olympians to feel perfectly at home in the capital. Athletes and tourists found this to be true, then it filled Moscow's heart with happiness and pride. Yeah. to 2 million spectators, the guests of the Olympic Games were able to attend the Olympic Arts Festival. To Moscow, but they sent their younger brothers instead, the Centenarians Ensemble of Abkhazia. The most temperamental member of the group is Timur Vanasha, a 114-year-old tea grower. As for these dancers, they are the great-grandchildren of the Centenarians, the state folk dance company of Georgia. State Dance Ensemble of the Ukraine came to the Olympic Games from Kiev. Mascot of the Olympic Games, Misha, performed in the circus. You can be sure he did a lot of training and strictly abided by the rules in order to win the right to appear at such a grand sports holiday. Sport, sport and art, they have a lot in common. The audience in the sports palace was thrilled by the show put on by the gymnasts. Two ace performers, Alexander Dityatin and Nikolai Andrianov, vied for the men's overall honors. The most intricate routines were executed expertly. Jatin's virtuosity fascinated both the spectators and the judges, who recognized him as the number one gymnast in the world. To guess who would win in the women's section because there were so many talented gymnasts on the Luzhniki platform. The audience was treated to a truly dramatic display of emotion, beauty, elegance, and daring. Many thought that Olympic champion Nadia Comăneci of Romania would win again. Others thought it would be the Soviet Union's young Natalia Shaposhnikova. Competition, Irina Davidova of Leningrad proved to be a bit more precise and a bit more elegant than the rest. She gradually increased her lead from exercise to exercise and rightfully emerged as the overall champion. Davidova, Olympic Games gold medal winner 1980. Put everything he had into this heave. It won him the Olympic gold medal in the hammer throw. Greatest of ease, Maria Colon of Cuba sent the javelin flying. To tell them apart in the Olympic Village, Anatoly is on the left and Sergei is on the right, unless it's the other way around. But generally speaking, it's not important. Both the twin Beloglazov brothers made the finals in the freestyle wrestling tournament. Anatoly is the older, born a quarter of an hour earlier than Sergei. Opponents in grand style. Now, is it Anatoly? No, it's Sergei. It's Anatoly's turn now. Brothers performed their Olympic concerto for four hands with real brilliance. For the first time in freestyle wrestling history, twins became Olympic champions. Anatoly and Sergei, Sergei and Anatoly, in general, that isn't important. They are the twin Beloglazov brothers. Greco-Roman wrestling. The greatest athlete of olden times was the wrestler Milo, a native of Crotona, who won in six consecutive Olympics. The Greeks compared him to Heracles. Milo remained unequaled for more than 20 years. It is said that he trained as a child by carrying a calf in his arms. Years passed, the calf grew into a full-size cow. Milo grew stronger and stronger and once carried a four-year-old bull into the Olympic Stadium. The six-time Olympic winner from Crotona was not only noted for his wrestling feats. Also as a disciple of Pythagoras, as an author of a number of scientific papers, Milo, the Olympic hero and scientist, was no exception. Pythagoras was an Olympic victor. Many great Greeks are linked with sports. Aristotle, Plato, Aeschylus the poet, Sophocles, Euripides, Socrates the philosopher, Herodotus the historian, Demosthenes the orator, and Hippocrates the father of medicine. Roger van der Waal of Belgium was the most temperamental on the mat. Two Frenchmen who captured gold medals demonstrated lightning quick thinking and anticipation as well as splendid judo techniques. Olympic boxing champion of Cuba, Teofilio Stevenson, looks like a winner as soon as he enters the tournament hall.
Oh!
Teofilio made it 3 Olympic gold medals in a row in Moscow. His first words of gratitude go to his Soviet mentor, Shevchenko, who spotted in this tall, lanky Cuban lad the makings of a future world-class boxer. Becoming stronger. May strength be kind and courage gentle. Among the women in the Olympic Games, is the Viennese rider Elizabeth Teure. The story behind her equestrian performance in Moscow is that the Austrian Equestrian Federation refused to subsidize the journey. But the brilliant horsewoman was not to be stopped. She flew to Moscow in a private plane of her friend, the professional race car driver, Niki Lauda, who brought her and her mount, Mon Cheri, a gray, to Sheremetyevo Airport at night. Elizabeth Taylor and Mon Cheri went on to take the Olympic dressage gold medal. In ancient Greece, women were not allowed to come to the Olympic Games. The Greek oracles foresaw what that would lead to. This was how a woman was supposed to be treated if she tried to get inside the sacred games in Olympia. But one time, an affectionate mother, Ferenica, taught her son Poseidon how to fight with his fists and prepared him for the Olympic Games. Dressed as a man, she arrived in Olympia, and together with a group of pedotribus, as trainers were called at that time, she made her way inside the stadium to watch Poseidon in action. Overwhelmed by her son's victories over all his adversaries, the mother rushed forward to embrace him. She dropped her male tunic in haste, revealing that she was a woman. Under law, Ferenica was supposed to be thrown off a cliff. But the judges pardoned her as the mother of an Olympic champion. This proved to be an historic precedent for the violation of Olympic laws. The main thing was to make a start. Supposedly trail behind those of the men by only half a century. At any rate, men's records in the initial Olympic Games have long since been eclipsed by the women. There was a time when women were called the weaker sex. Show a determination, a desire to win, and a perseverance that make the stronger sex blush. Women are sure that not only flowers and dresses become them, but that their gold victory medals also look better on them. enchantresses of the Olympic Games. Yes, indeed. Without you, the Olympic Games would not be as romantic or moving. Your tears and smiles are wonderful. And how talkative the men become when you fight furiously for victory.
But it's Busse on the inside. Ovet striding out now. On the stretch, and it's Ovet and Busse. Guimara is trying to catch them. Ovet showing his class, going ahead. Coming to the line, and Steve Ovet winning the semi-final. Busse of East Germany is second, and a great one.
Und Irina Nazarova führt auf der Bahn Nummer 1. Und wo ist Caroline Käfer? Im Augenblick an der zweiten Stelle. Das wäre also großartig. Caroline, geh's an, noch 50 Meter. Aber direkt neben ihr kämpft Judith Forgatsch. Und jetzt geht in diesem Augenblick Irene Schewinskan hier vorbei und außen noch.
C'est bien parti pour West, qui est à l'extérieur également. Le Cuba Lara qui jaillit à la ligne numéro 7. Elle lutte aussi avec Sylvain Léonard à la corde. Léonard West. Bando termine à la 8e place. Silvio Leonard pour nous est le vainqueur.
Adib. Des coups sur là. Pour le marque maintenant, il y a Varen. Kirov. Yentasar Kirov. Varen pour le marque maintenant. Marajo Yerja, le marque maintenant.
A shot from 25 meters. Beats best to get it by flat. He almost stopped it. But then we had told you that his two legs are bad. Under normal circumstances, he suddenly would have stopped it.
El marcador 0-0 aquí en el estadio Dinamo de Moscú. Si su televisor no es Zenit, usted no puede hablar de imagen y sonido. Si su televisor no es Zenit, usted no puede hablar de imagen y calidad.
Está llevándose la pelota el número 11, Jamal con el balón. Hay pase atrasado ahora sobre el costado izquierdo. La pelota para el número 5, Malé con el balón. El árbitro dice que se coloca el esférico.
Eder González para Biafara. Parece que Retalla dijo, bueno, 30 ya calentamos a este personal de Kuwait porque ha salido Biafara de la cueva. Cambia juego sobre Pelufo. El pase es atrasado, la pelota se abre, se pierde. Servicio lateral que favorece al equipo de Kuwait.
Competition was exceptionally keen in the Olympic football games. They were played in four cities, Leningrad, Kiev, Minsk, and Moscow. Czechoslovakia opposed the German Democratic Republic in the finals. The one goal scored by Svoboda gave the Czechoslovakian team its 1-0 Olympic victory.
Trzyma! Urywaj się! Tak, no! Urywaj się! Urywaj się! Nie przyjmuj tego, urywaj się!
The Moscow Olympics were going into the last lap. The time has come to give credit to those people who exert a decisive influence on the course of the competitions, though remaining unnoticed by most of the spectators. Those people are the trainers. The architects of victory, the stage managers of an unforgettable and vivid show, of a thrilling sports spectacle. They deserve everyone's deepest respect.
Or the token key to the Chateau de Vivi
Lord Killinan passes on the symbolic key to the new president of the International Olympic Committee, Juan Antonio Samaranch. Mr. Samaranch said,
"Los Juegos Olímpicos de Moscú han terminado ya."
It can be stated in all confidence that the Moscow Olympic Games were a success, not only from a point of view of organization, but also from a point of view of attained sports standards. It can be said that these were grand Olympic Games, as testified by 36 world standards established during them. We are highly pleased with the standards shown here in Moscow.
Азарта, добрый мир, спортивных встреч, всем понятны песни стартов и секунд прямая речь. Мы запомним эти мгновения, будем мы всегда хранить красоту и вдохновение.
Athletes from 81 countries, the envoys of all five continents on the planet, competed for the sake of peace and friendship, for the sake of the beauty of sport. For many, Moscow became the happiest city in the world. As many as 74 Olympic, 36 world, 39 European, and hundreds of national records were set in the Olympiad 80. The 1980 Olympic Games proved to be a victory for the Olympic movement and the Olympic ideals. Lord Killinan, President of the International Olympic Committee.
Sportsmen gathered here for the Games of the 22nd Olympiad have shown their great friendship, despite their varying colors, religious or political philosophies, in fair competition. The standards and records of the many individuals are ample proof of the great performances obtained at these games. And I only grieve for those who were not able to participate. In the name of the International Olympic Committee, I offer to President Brezhnev and the people of the Soviet Union our best wishes. I declare the games of the 22nd Olympiad closed.
The days of the Olympiad have flown by. The time has come to say farewell to the Olympic Games. Thank you.
твой сказочный лес. Пожелаем друг другу успеха, мы добра и любви без конца. Олимпийское звонкое эхо остается в стихах и сердцах. До свидания, Москва, до свидания, олимпийская сказка, прощай. Пожелай исполнения желаний, новой встречи, друзья, пожелай. Расстаются друзья, остается в сердце небо.